Fast food hot dogs can satisfy a multitude of appetites, as long as you order them from the right place. These are the top dogs ranked from worst to best. Supermarket food court options are included as well because they are also fast enough and delicious enough. Rumors of poor hot dog quality at Dairy Queen have been circulating for at least a decade. In 2010, a Reddit commenter who claimed to work at a DQ said that the hot dogs were reheated and reused day after day until they were sold. Another commenter said that didn't happen at the DQ they worked at, but other employees who posted on Quora claim that people should avoid the hot dogs and that the way the chili is prepared for the chili cheese dogs is, quote, really disgusting. Dairy Queen has used an all-beef hot dog since 2007, though they're of the skinless variety with no snappy casing that pops when you bite into them. As it turns out, they're not very popular. A Business Insider fast food reviewer in 2016, for example, cited the Dairy Queen chili dog as the worst menu item she's eaten from any fast food restaurant. And then there's the review from Fast Food Menu Prices, which declared that the chili cheese dog wiener tastes like low-grade meat. Simply put, there's not much going for Dairy Queen in the hot dog department. It's best to just stick to the blizzards when you go there. The full name of the Five Guys chain is Five Guys Burgers and Fries. And even though hot dogs isn't in the official name, they still make a very tasty dog. They use a Hebrew National hot dog, which is sliced lengthwise and cooked on the griddle, so it's crisp on the outside and inside. As for toppings, mustard and maybe some relish is the way to go, though raw onions and Kraft American cheese are acceptable additions on the cheese dog if that's something you're into. There's even an option for a bacon dog and a bacon cheese dog. All of these are fine selections. This type of praise isn't normally lavished on a food item that's close to last in a ranking. But there's a sticking point here. As Five Guys prices its hot dogs at more than $5 for the most basic version at many locations and racks it up to $7 or more for additions like bacon and cheese, a single Hebrew National hot dog with basic condiments and a basic bun simply shouldn't cost this much. For perspective, a pack of 7 Hebrew Nationals can cost less than $4 at Walmart. Hot dogs are cheap and quick hunger fixes, even by fast food standards. So while Five Guys deserves to place higher from a pure taste perspective, they have to drop down a bit, as only the most decorated and crafty of hot dogs should command these prices. There are a lot of good hot dogs in the world, and a lot of bad ones. And there are also a lot of ones that are just fine. The last category is where we find Checkers, or Rallies, depending on what part of the country you live in. The price is just right at around $1 for a basic dog, and there's a chili dog option for when you want something a little messier. But there's nothing that really makes a Checkers beefy hot dog on a toasted bun stand out. That hasn't stopped Checkers from feeling pride about their Franks, though. In 2016, the chain released a series of ads about Burger King's short-lived phase of selling hot dogs. The campaign was filled with cringe-inducing lines like, "It's time to compare wieners," and "Overcompensating anyone?" As if that wasn't enough, the campaign also joked that Checkers was promoting its dogs because Burger King was showing its wiener in public for the first time. A side of sophomoric jokes doesn't make an average hot dog taste any better. Few hot dogs can compare to the reputation of Nathan's Famous. It's the centerpiece of the most famous hot dog eating contest in the world, and it's the standard for ballpark hot dog stands and beachside shacks. Nathan's Famous can also be found on supermarket shelves, but they're best from a stand. The dog itself is just the right amount of sweet and salty, and the meat is juicy and full of all-beef flavor without being watery or oily. Nathan's Famous sells around 550 million hot dogs annually for a reason. The brand claims to use the same recipe that was invented by Polish immigrant Nathan Hanwerker. Nathan's hot dogs became famous more than 100 years ago in Brooklyn's Coney Island, long before famous was officially part of the name. Grabbing a hot dog from the original shack on the boardwalk deserves to be on every hot dog lover's bucket list. A simple hot dog with mustard from a Nathan's Famous stand rarely disappoints. It tastes best when it's eaten after a long day spent relaxing on the beach and riding roller coasters. It seems like everyone in Chicago has an opinion on the best place to get a Chicago hot dog. The style consists of mustard, relish, celery salt, onion, tomato, pickle, and peppers on a poppy seed bun. It's sometimes known as a hot dog that's dragged through the garden because of all the toppings. It is one of the best ways to eat a hot dog, as it's full of tangy acidity, umami, and salt that all complement an all-beef dog. Portillo's does a fine job with its Chicago-style hot dogs. There may be some small shops that do it better, but this chain is about the closest you can get when you're looking for a Chicago dog outside Illinois. Since its humble start in a trailer in 1963, the chain has spread to other states like Arizona, California, and Florida. The menu features basic hot dogs as well as chili dogs. The best option is to go with the classic to have a taste of Chicago delivered fast casual style. Each hot dog has more filling than any of the comparatively skimpy options you'll find at other chains. But if you're still looking for something a little more significant, just ask for a jumbo, which is simply the same but with a thicker Frank. While the many condiment options at IKEA can make assembling your hot dog about as complicated as assembling a piece of IKEA furniture, there's no denying the Swedish store makes some tasty dogs. They're often overshadowed by more popular items like the Swedish meatballs, but they're nevertheless well worth trying out. The particular details of your IKEA hot dog experience depend on where you're located. In the United States, IKEA's hot dogs are a mix of chicken and beef. Large, fluffy buns hold it all together with the condiments on the bottom if you want. What really makes IKEA stand out is that it makes a veggie hot dog that actually tastes good. It's made with sustainability in mind, as it consists of kale, lentils, quinoa, onions, and wheat protein. If you're not strictly vegan or vegetarian, you can always go for the classic meat version. But it's always nice to have options, especially if you're concerned about the environment. Wiener Schnitzel is like the Nathan's Famous of the West Coast, even though it's probably not quite as famous. But it's still pretty successful in its own right, with some 120 million hot dog sales every year. And it does that with locations in only 10 states. Options are king at Wiener Schnitzel. Before you order, decide whether you want a pretzel bun or a regular bun, and whether you want a dog that's the world-famous original style, all beef, or Polish. The chain started in Southern California in 1961. Today, there are a number of options that will satisfy any type of hot dog craving, which helps push it ahead of some competitors on this list. There's a relish dog and a bacon street dog, as well as a green chili cheese dog, and a plain dog known simply as the mustard dog. There's even a Chicago dog that's been dragged through the garden. It's probably most famous for what the company describes as its uber-famous chili that's smothered on the chili dog. What you won't find is actual Wiener Schnitzel, which is a pounded, breaded, and fried piece of veal. But if you're going to Wiener Schnitzel for the hot dogs, as you should be, you'll leave satisfied.
We did it!
In 1985, Costco began selling a hot dog with a soda for $1.50. That price remains the same to this day, and it's just about the best hot dog meal deal you can find anywhere. That said, Costco's prime hot dogs are far from a secret. Food writer Kevin Pang has praised them in the Chicago Tribune, and there are clearly plenty of people who agree with him. In 2015, Costco sold 128 million hot dogs. Though the price has stayed the same over the past 3.5 decades, the dog itself has changed, as Costco swapped Hebrew National out for Kirkland in 2009. The quarter-pound all-beef hot dog is actually 10% larger than Hebrew National's, and it's free of artificial flavors and fillers. In 2018, Costco got rid of its Polish dog to make room for healthy options, much to the dismay of fans. But the regular old hot dog is still good enough. Top it up with all of the complimentary condiments you enjoy, and eat it right away for full enjoyment of the steam bun and all that it contains. Sonic's All-American Hot Dog is, simply put, a hot dog done right. It's loaded with ketchup, yellow mustard, relish, and chopped onions without being overly full. Though if you prefer a simpler hot dog, you'll still be satisfied on the flavor front. The true draw when it comes to Sonic, though, is the chili cheese coney, which is smothered in an all-meat chili and melted cheddar cheese. It's made in the true coney style, which is defined by a steam bun, beanless chili, and white onions. It's believed that the coney was invented in the early 1900s in Michigan by Greek immigrants who had tried Nathan's Famous hot dogs on Coney Island. At Sonic, the coney is a filling load of flavor. It's messy, but the toppings won't all fall off before you get into it. Still, you'll probably want to eat it outside of your car just to be safe. If you're in the mood to go big or go home, opt for the foot-long quarter-pound coney, which is a blend of beef and pork. While the weight is the same as the dogs at Costco and Sam's Club, it's elongated rather than chunky, which leaves plenty of room for the chili in between the buns.
That's not what your hot dog can put on you, but what you can put on your hot dog.
Shake Shack is known for its Shack Burgers. The chicken sandwich has also gotten a lot of love since it was first released in 2015. But the original Shake Shack menu option is the hot dog, and it's the best fast food hot dog on the market. In 2001, the first Shake Shack hot dog cart opened in Manhattan's Madison Square Park. The goal was to support the Madison Square Park Conservancy's first art installation. The cart drew crowds for 3 summers until a permanent spot opened in 2004, which eventually transformed into the national burger chain we know and love today. And it all started with a hot dog.
This little hot dog cart would attract a line of 60 or 70 people. And in 2004, we finally said, let's turn this into a full kiosk.
Shake Shack's dogs are butterfly, or flat top as the company puts it, like how the ones at Five Guys are. For just over $3 or $4 for Chicago style, you get a juicy yet crispy Vienna beef hot dog that can hold all its toppings in thanks to the butterfly's style. It's all served in an airy and lightly sweet Martin's potato roll. If you're in the mood for something extra, you have the option to add the house-made cheese sauce, which is a blend of cheddar and American. However you do it, the Shake Shack original is worth every penny. Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more mashed videos about your favorite fast foods are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.